urgent, LA police declare Hollyweird as home of liberal sexual deviancy. This statement will end them. Recently, the LA police began an investigation into Harvey Weinstein, but now that appears to be just the tip of the liberal perversion iceberg. The LA police say they are conducting 28 sexual assault allegations and that they turned down another 37 cases deemed to be out of their jurisdiction. They have also hinted that some of the cases they are handling are about major stars in the entertainment industry. Since conservatives are not welcome in Hollyweird, it's a safe bet that most or all of the offenders are liberals. The LA police have made this a major investigation, appointing two teams of five detectives, each with a group of cold case detectives thrown in to work on the older cases that are not beyond the statute of limitations. It's bitterly ironic that the party who is always lecturing conservatives on how to treat women are the worst sexual predators in America. And the victims are also liberals, but they've kept their mouths shut for decades, taking only a brief respite to trash conservatives with the bogus war on women hoax. Considering the seriousness of the charges, which include actual rape, you would think there would be more outrage from the lame stream press who claim to be on the side of sexual assault victims, but I guess that doesn't hold true when the perpetrators are also liberals. Morning Joe and his wife Mika held a panel that made the claim that the Republican Party is the party of pedophilia. This is based solely on the rapidly disintegrating accusations made against Judge Roy Moore. They didn't mention Jerry Stutz, who was caught banging an underage page, or Bill Clinton's mini rides on the Lolita Express, or Sin Menendez's trips to Orgy Island with its underage hookers. Why is that? Also, remember that many of the Hollyweird assault cases involve underage actresses and actors. From The Hill. If your moral code doesn't dictate that you come out strongly against someone who's been accused of these things, maybe a political, strategic argument would prevail on the president, which is that you win this seat, this Senate seat for Roy Moore. It's a Pyrrhic victory because you will be saddled, as you all have just said, as the party of a pedophiles for the rest of Roy Moore's term, panelist Willie Geist said. Then in that case you get the worst of all worlds where you lose the seat, and in the process of losing it you've become the party of pedophiles, panelist John Howman added. So, one false accusation is worse than dozens of proven cases? Are we the only ones who find these undereducated fops to be hypocritical? We doubt it. These accusations are just wagging the dog by liberals trying to distract attention from themselves. Police Chief Charlie Beck said that although cases like Corey Feldman's are too old to prosecute, the LA police force want victims to come forward with their stories, we assume because they may want to find out if there are some more recent victims. After all, rapists and others who employ sexual assaults as a way of having power over women usually do not change their spots and continue until they are caught like Weinstein was. The LA police are working closely with veteran lawyers in the DA's office who specialize in sex crimes. The prosecutor's office claim that they don't intend to play favorites just because of a person's fame. Quite frankly, we would feel more secure if they swore to prosecute people regardless of their political ideology or how much they contribute to any particular political party.